as Nox able to take down Kareev. Verbo then falls. That pushes over. That's over. That's all your healing. You're done. Bye.
A good friend of ours is able to back out. And Unco right now, plenty of room to work with. Fate is down, and this is looking very good for Rogue as they start pushing the issue. Unco goes down, but at what cost? Rogue is very much winning the trade-outs here.
They've been catching Fate's dive very, very well. And though Fate and Agility has worked well together earlier today, it seems like it's been just a half a second off for them. Have to play the point. No more choices left. And they do barely touch the point as, yeah, that is it. Rogue will take Hollywood in convincing fashion. Not just a stall tactic, a kill tactic.
Barrier in from the defense, Transcendence in on the offense. Kareev dancing in about, self-destruct over the top. AKM connects. Fate out of the equation for now as Rogue finds the proper counter engage. And I'm going to sound like a broken record here, but this keeps happening on second, where the final fight.
Well, that was Nico, actually, able to get back in his. Envy still holding on to this. Soon takes out his counterpart. There's Envy self-destruct.
Envy self-destruct coming in, and this is decent here for the defense. They've gotten some key kills that they need. Rogue, despite being pushed back, they have only 6 seconds left to defend, and Immortals, they cannot back out. Normally, they'd go for reset here.
Jumps
you
out.
Can't.
Just
you gotta get on the payload.
Literally they just can't. Jumped out as soon as we said that.
So, last moment defense coming out here from Immortals, trying to buy some time, but Grim dove on immediately by AKM. Nico just sitting here trying to follow up on the Discord. Or what's Kareev opening some things up here? And yet Nico, Transcendence Blade out. I don't think there's a response. Nico able to finish out the last part of this fight with style. 3 kills and a point captured. Rogue on the way.
Yeah, it's still not very far away.
Soon looking to creep in from the opposite flank of the rest of his team. Most of Rogue going the high ground soon. Down and dirt to the back. The pulse bomb doesn't stick. It does. Kareev out of the fight. And this might finally be the break that Rogue is needed because they have been gummed up here for way too long. AKM though. Attack visor over the top. That's going to be the cherry on top for an excellent Rogue strike set up by Sue. Well, I do tend to agree. Agility's has shown us better play overall in Pharah historically, but not this time. AKM, 2 rockets, 2 agilities gut, and oh my god, Kareev takes one to the face. I want to apologize to the Immortals Nation because it does not connect.
Does not, but it does distract for a moment so that they can come in. Self-destruct comes over top, takes out Agilities.
That was so long range. How does that even hit at that point? But it does, and AKM is right there in the follow-through. Verbo trying to stay alive. Can't wall ride his way out of that one.
The important part, actually, is that AKM did follow through and was able to take down.
So now you see Immortals respecting that, backing up a bit themselves, and it's just this back and forth between both teams that soon opens it up in the back, gets on the Kareev, and that might be all Rogue needs here on the control center.
This should be a map that they're much, or a stage rather, that they're much
team to get their ults online before you get your second fight. And Grim, tearing through the Steve armor, throws the pulse bomb out. Not quite gonna connect on it as Soon gets him into the back.
I mean, they do get off the point though. Soon was busy murdering in the back lines. That is his third half kill there. He missed his pulse bomb onto Zen and then got mad about it and just shot Zen in the head. Soon takes out Agilities too, as they have to transcend. But meanwhile, all this percentage should be Rogue. Whatever percentage ends up on the clock should be on the other side, because that's a misstep.
Rogue should have kept control. Down. So, they'll dodge one there, effectively. Fate healed back up, and yeah, we'll take a look at Envy here. He's gonna dive into the back line, self-destruct on the way out. Do we have a winner? No. No, we don't. No one hit by that, and Immortals just getting crunched in this final fight. Kareev with a last moment desperation transcendence, but just about everything going the way of Rogue here. Agilities could build up a blade, but he has to get out of the self-destruct first. He doesn't. He's down.
That pulse bomb that Soon hit almost could have really backfired because it
Doherty, not letting Soon get to the back line. The rest of Immortals going to deep dive into this fight, but you can't ignore Soon. He gets onto Grim, and just like that, Rogue might have bought themselves an advantage already.
That is a couple of quick kills. In fact, both tanks now out of the mix. The dive.
And now Rogue gets a kill right back in.
Well, they all dove in. Look what's happening with Soon. He's pushing the cart. He took down the Lucio in there as well. And now here's the greeting party for the retreat. Oh, he doesn't have recall. He's going to have recall now. He will recall right out of that. Get back to his team. Nice play, Soon.
Yep. Soon getting back onto the payload. And that worked out really well. And Soon is the one who started it out. He made Kareev uncomfortable. They had to go earlier on the engage than they wanted to, and Rogue was prepared as Unco can't believe his eyes that self-destruct killed him. once more. The ebb and flow in this game has been insane.
Agilities dives in with his friend Fate. They have been partners in crime all day, but Nox takes Agilities out. That means Fate is a little bit unprotected. They have to bail out. Nox doing so much damage and none being returned to him. The dive comes in moderately. Fate now out of this fight. Momentum firmly in Rogue's hands.
And look at AKM. He has so much room here over the top. Plenty of sight lines. Attack visor in reserve. Sue might be doing the work right now, but AKM is the threat going into this.
Is there the greed of that is service in the denying you anything you want to do type of way. And oh, they go into the upper room in an uneven fight, and that goes very poorly for Immortals there. Rogue coming out really strong in this first point.
Unko down.
Well, Unko is already down, but Nico, a blade of his own before Agilities can even unsheath his blade. Nico going wild right now on this point A defense, and Agilities is hoping no one notices him on the point, but Blade coming out here. This is a Rogue cleanup as Immortals tries to hold on, but that EMP should seal their fate. Yet, no kills come in the immediate aftermath of the EMP, but wow. There we go. Now, they roll it.
Just a little bit slow to come in. No progress on the points.
You have a little bit of poking coming in here from the side. Agilities holding onto Blade, and he That's strikes nice. Nico down immediately. The threat is gone. Nico's been the backbone for Rogue here. And yet, Nox pulling it right back, smacks Agilities in the grill, and Rogue coming right back despite what could have been a tough opening. Monica right now for sure. Rogue coming back in here once more. They do have one upside. The blade is on the way. Nico looking towards people that would stymie him. Sees Fate in the corner. The rest of Rogue going up the gut, and they take down Kareev. There will be no EMP this time. He had it, wasn't able to get it off in time. And now Nico looking. Four targets here on the floor, and this would be really big for Rogue if they could get through this without using the Blade Hex.
Well, two down already. We'll see what alts are used on this defense to try to keep Rogue from taking the point. It is also Immortal style to know when the fight is
next. Hits at least four people. Rogue with a big opportunity here. Let's see if AKM is able to do enough. They lost Nox, though, and the counter EMP is out. The window might have already been slammed shut.
Kareev gets a couple of kills. The Blossom will take down Envy out of mech, but that is it for AKM. Unko gets in there. They have gotten a tick onto the point. Nico wants a little more.
Where's my health back? But he does get the health back in time. The barrier is out, and Rogue not out of this here just yet. Continuing pressure coming in. Immortals on the back foot as Rogue finding their window, taking them down on the point, and about to get the EMP up. It's still going to be in time before Kareev gets his. How does Unko initiate this? He's looking for the right target. Is that it? He throws the EMP right into the room. He gets hacked from behind while this goes on, and the kills not coming in as swift as Rogue might like here. It's more even for Immortals. But Nico! That could be game-winning! The self-destruct into the back takes down three!
Go in the double down and going on the dive into the room.
Everyone have to
fade out. Fade out.
Fate's gonna fall here, though. They're already down two. Immortals down to their last four men here. Rogue, they only need a tick for championship victory. They're getting the kills they need. AKM, plenty of room. Lots of space here on the point. Grim and Kareev, the final people here to stall, but the point is going down. They must get onto the point now. Rogue, so close to victory, close to the championship, and it will be Rogue defeating Immortals in a thriller, ending on Volskaya. They are your beat Overwatch Invitational champions.
An amazing set, a gift to the Overwatch watching community.